say small.
The blue helmets have arrived. These blue helmets have been holding peace in many parts of the world and a source of steadfast commitment. 29th of May marks the International Day of United Nations Peacekeepers. India has been a major contributor to United Nations peacekeeping missions. India currently deploys more than 7,600 military and police personnel to United Nations peacekeeping operations in Afghanistan, Congo, Haiti, Lebanon, Liberia, the Middle East, South Sudan, Sudan, and the Western Sahara. 163 Indian peacekeepers have sacrificed their lives in the line of duty under the United Nations flag. India was the first country to contribute a female force to the United Nations mission in Liberia.
I can tell you in any form, in the front runner position, it is the Indian, whether it's in the combat zone or it is in the staff work or our presence anywhere. In fact, the hospitals also, they have been doing a marvelous job of saving number of lives and other things.
This year, two Indian peacekeepers, rifleman Brajesh Thapa, who served with the United Nations Organization Stabilization Mission in the Democratic Republic of Congo, and Private Ravi Kumar, who have been deployed with the United Nations Interim Force in Lebanon, posthumously receiving the Dag Hammarskjöld Medal this year. India has been providing training to peacekeeping officers from a large number of countries, including more than 800 officers from 82 countries. India has provided over 2 lakh troops in nearly 50 of the 71 peacekeeping missions mandated over past 6 decades.
International Day of United Nations Peacekeepers pays tribute to all the men and women who have served under the UN banner for their courage, commitment and dedication. India deserves a special mention. India is the second largest troop contributor to the United Nations peacekeeping missions. It shows India's commitment towards multilateralism through peacekeeping missions. With cameraperson Smriti Siddhan Sibbal, DD News, New Delhi.
North Korea has